How are you?
It was difficult.
Well, we had a vote which was rather unusual for Greece because we actually legalized.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. And you?
A country in the southeastern Europe.
Yes.
By far, you know, if I welcome you.
No. Okay, yeah. Good to see you.
Because we legalized gay
I
marriage
saw that.
Yesterday, I saw very that. Late.
Yes.
So, I tell you the news here, bro.
Good to see you again.
Good to see you.
How are you? Please. We. If I look a little tired, it is because.
Final pictures.
Lynn is one of my best friends in Amsterdam. I really appreciate that you can see us.
Yeah, it's
great.
It's a pleasure.
For a lot of making a great job for your country.
Well, what a pleasure.
I'll send you my mobile number.
Wonderful. Okay. Okay. Thank you so much. I guess France is a king of woods.
It was courageous.
Good. It was good.
Hello.
We made it.
We did.
Yeah.
We made it.
How are you?
Hello. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Thank you very much. And indeed, it's a privilege to be participating in this gathering. And let me start by observing how important it is to be sitting around the same table with the big tech companies. You made a reference, started by making a reference to Athens as the cradle of democracy, and of course Athenian democracy was a direct democracy, wasn't a representative democracy, but this does not mean that it was not immune to rumors or populism. Many of the deep thinking that went into the ancient thinkers that wrote about ancient democracy is still not capable of creating a convincing hologram of me walking in a Greek village doing a traditional campaigning work. It may happen at some point, but it also allows us to think again in terms of not putting all our faith in terms of communicating with the general public in a campaign simply by using the most advanced technological tools. So again, as a head of government that thinks a lot about the future of democracy and about protecting the integrity of the democratic process, congratulations on this initiative. I think it's a clear step in the right direction. And let's also think about how we can use AI tools to make the democratic process better in terms of making public consultations more effective and more objective. So let's look at the flip side of this, and we'll be looking for your contribution. What can AI do to make public engagement better in order to build sort of more trust between the elected officials and the general public?